Next question is from Cassidy Hoffman Official. Can my body adapt to NEAT in the same way it would to cardio? Y'all talk about body adapting to cardio in a way that you'll have to keep adding more for it to be effective. Will the NEAT I employ to prevent weight gain do the same?
All right. So if we're talking about calorie burn and fat loss and that kind of stuff, yeah, your body starts to burn less calories. Your body starts to adapt. But here's the problem. And I think sometimes when people hear us talk about this, they get the message that that's all the value of cardiovascular activity or NEAT is the fat burning effect. There's another side to this, which is it's good for you. Mm-hmm. You don't have to burn more. You don't have to get ripped. You don't have to burn more calories. It's just good for you to move. In fact, sitting down all day long is worse for you than smoking cigarettes and as bad as having a bad diet. So who cares? Who cares? It's just good for you. It's good for your health. It's good for your mental health. Good for your physical health. Reduces inflammation. Lowers your risk of cancer, heart disease, diabetes, everything. So forget the fat loss. I think sometimes we get so focused on how is it going to make me look, we forget about how good it is for you.
That's because we come out and we talk about that, right? Because that's the number one thing that you get asked as a trainer. Is everybody wants to know the fastest way to lose fat, to get in shape, or to look a certain way. And so we address the cardio thing from that perspective so often. It does not mean that we don't think that there's tremendous value in somebody doing a 30-minute bout of cardio every single day. I think that's or an hour even. That's great. If it's something that's a part of your lifestyle and you can maintain that forever, but absolutely the body will adapt to that and it will not be the best way for you to lean out. So you really got to, you have to know who we're trying to communicate that information to. We're communicating it to the masses that think that cardio is a great way to lose body
fat. Yeah, and if they I only have 3 hours a week, Sal, what should I do to burn body fat? Well, if you only have 3 hours a week, lift weights.
Right.
That's the most effective way. Right. But yeah, moving is good for you, period.
Well, and even if you put them apples to apples, you got that 1 hour block or whatever, and like you burn X amount of calories in that 1 hour block versus, you know, all day long, you're just up, you're active, you're moving. We've seen this. We've tested this. Like how much more effective you are at even burning calories. But yeah, like to what you brought up, it's just beneficial. It's beneficial. You're getting things done in your house. You're expressing all the joints in your body. You're pumping blood constantly throughout the day. There's just so many recuperative elements to that versus like trying to then now add a very specific stress to your body to get your body fat to lower.
Totally. And one more thing, and I'll make this argument all day long. 1 hour of cardio done all at once versus 3 20-minute bouts of cardio or whatever. Okay. Everything being equal, the difference is one is done all at once. The other one's done throughout the day. The one done throughout the day will have superior benefits.
More carryover to other things.
Across the board. Yep. It's better. It's going to be better for health, joint health, brain health. It'll probably be better even for fat loss to a small degree. It's better to move throughout the day than to dedicate 1 hour of movement and then the rest of the day sit down, even if the time is all equal.
But back to comparing to NEAT, like NEAT is technically not none of the exercise. Even walking is technically not NEAT. I know we've discussed it as if it was. Like NEAT is supposed to be non-exercise activity that you mindlessly do, which would be more like a tick, right? A tick or moving around a little bit in your seat. Like that is like non-exercise movement throughout the day. No matter what it is, your body adapts to everything. And it doesn't take very long for it to start to adapt, and then you lose the benefits of the fat burning from it, right? It's not that ideal, but it still doesn't take away from why you should be active all day long. So it's one of those conversations I feel like we continually have to repeat ourselves that we've been labeled as these like non-cardio guys, and that's just because 90% of all clients that ever hired one of us, if not more than that, wanted to lose body fat. Mm-hmm. And they think that cardio is the best way to do it. And so we're always having to address this.
Well, guaranteed 99% of people haven't just deliberately focused on like increasing the amount of activity they have versus like thinking they have to do cardio. So that's why we highlight that more than the other. And there's another way to do this. And, you know, eventually you'll get adapted to it. But I would love to see you try.
That's right. Very, very good point.